Alright, good afternoon. Chalo, let's start karte hain. Abhi kaha chal raha apna house property. Income from house property mein kitne section hai? Section 22 to section 27. Alright, section 22 is a charging section. Charging section has three conditions. First condition, there should be house property. House property should be owned by assessee. And such house property shall not be used for own business or profession. Alright. House property means building and land appurtenant thereto. Alright. Ownership also includes beneficial ownership and deemed ownership. And if house property is used for business, then income from such house property will be assessed under the head PGBP, not under the head house property. Then we have discussed types of properties. What types of property we have yesterday? We started discussion, come on, tell me. Let out property. And second property is self-occupied property. Let out property will be called as a let out property if it was let out for any period during the previous year. Alright, then the status will become LOP. Let out property is always taxable. Alright, and self-occupied property can be of two types. Self-occupied for business. Business is excluded, so it is not taxable. Another property is self-occupied for residence. A residential property should not be taxable because there is no actual rent. Alright, but Government of India has said only one, and which one? Anyone, alright, that is your choice. Any one property can be taken as SOP. Any one property can be taken as SOPR, self-occupied property for residence, of which NAV will be taken as, hello, NAV will be taken as nil. This property will have NAV as nil. And what about remaining? Remaining, reply karo. Deemed to be let out property. Alright. And deemed to be let out property is taxable or exempt? Taxable. And here we have discussed yesterday with the statement, assessee will be sad here. Why? Because he has to pay tax. There is an income, there is tax. Alright. Assessee will be crying here. Why? There is no income, but still he has to pay tax. Alright. And here assessee will be very happy. Why? Because there is no income, no tax, but still government is giving him deduction, and that deduction is nothing but encouragement to purchase house property, and that has to be there. Yes or no? Alright. So, and then why, sir? Why there is no rent, but still the property is taxable? Or here, property was laid out for 3 months, and self-occupied for 9 months. 3 months and 9 months. Alright. But still it will be called as let out property, and let out property, the net annual value will be taxable. Annual value will become taxable. Although it was let out for only 3 months, but still whole value is taxable. Here there is no rent, but still it is taxable. Why? Because in this chapter of house property, rent is not taxable. Rent earning capacity, and that capacity is annual capacity which is taxable under this chapter. Am I clear? Alright, so in this chapter we tax annual capacity. Sir, how to determine annual capacity? That is given under section 23. How do we compute annual capacity? Come on, tell me one more time. How do we compute? We start with municipal value. Municipal value will be compared with fair rent. Out of this, whichever is higher. This amount will be compared with standard rent. Out of this two, which you take, whichever is lower. That amount will give us expected rent. Expected rent will be compared with actual rent. And out of this, whichever is higher, is your gross annual value. From gross annual value, we subtract municipal taxes paid by owner. Paid by owner, then you will get net annual value. From net annual value, we do subtract two deductions. Only two deductions are there. Section 24 has only two deductions, 24A and 24B. 24A talks about standard deduction. Yes or no? Of 30%. Standard deduction of 30%. 30% of what? Net annual value. Sir, in this chapter, income is also taxable on notional basis. Income is taxable on notional basis. And expenses are also given on notional basis. Actual income is also not relevant and actual expenses are also not relevant. Alright, only one actual expenses is relevant, and that is interest on borrowed fund. Interest on borrowed fund. Alright, and interest on borrowed fund will be allowed as deduction. But there are three types of properties which are taxable here: LOP, DLOP and SOP. Alright, LOP will have limited deduction or unlimited deduction? LOP, productive property. Will government have hesitation to give deduction to LOP? No, therefore there is no limit on LOP. What about DLOP? No limit, because this is also productive property, income generating property. While giving deduction, they will not hesitate. But this property, SOPR, SOPR is a property where government will obviously hesitate, because that is an encouragement section. There is no tax, but still we are giving you deduction, and that deduction will result into loss in that column, and that loss will set off your other taxable income. Hello, and because of this kind of thing, your tax liability will come down. See, it is a positive thing for SSE, but negative thing for government. And their government cannot give you unlimited deduction. Tomorrow, if you are a rich person, you will buy plot at you. Alright, 150 crore will be a cost of house. For 150 crore cost, you will take loan, you will be paying 20-25 crore interest. That much interest we will not give you as a deduction. Government is not encouraging that people. Government is encouraging lower class, middle class, to buy house property. You understand? So person who can afford 40-50 lakh rupees house, they are being encouraged here. So 40 lakh rupees loan, approximately 1 year interest will be around 2.5 lakh, 3 lakh. Government is giving deduction of 2 lakh, maximum 2 lakh. If you are buying a house property in Naigaon, Vasai, that area, alright, how your loan amount will be around 25 lakh, annual interest will be around 1,80,000, 1,70,000. Maximum amount we are giving as a 2 lakh, you understand? But if you are a rich person, you wanted to buy property in Bandra and Dadar and those areas, like 5 crore property, 10 crore property, then also you will get deduction, but maximum you will pay 25 lakh rupees interest, but you will get deduction only 2 lakh, because maximum amount of deduction is written only for SOPR, only for SOPR. There is no limit on DLOP and LOP, because if your property is in Bandra, that property obviously will generate more rent, and more rent will become taxable, so government will be okay for giving more deduction, or no limited deduction, unlimited deduction. You understand? Alright, so this is very important concept of today's discussion that we have already started. Next section that we have written, we started writing some sentence concept based on our statements. Alright, so I believe yesterday we have written concept number 3. Concept number 3 was your municipal value. What is municipal value? Come on, tell me, what is municipal value? Value determined by, come on, tell me, local authority. What is fair rent? Fair rent is a market rent. What is standard rent? Standard rent is given in Rent Control Act. Alright, what is expected rent? Expected rent is the outcome of municipal value compared with fair rent, whichever is higher, and then compare with standard rent, whichever is lower. That isn't just a mathematical output, you understand? Expected rent has to be compared with actual rent. Alright, actual rent, I guess it was, I taught you, but it was not recorded, so allow me to teach you one more time. Alright, actual rent. Sir, what is the concept number of actual rent? 7. Concept 7 of actual rent. Concept 7, actual rent. Alright, this concept you must understand, because there is one section in future which will be section 25A, recovery of unrealized rent. Alright, for us that section is more important, but still here you need to understand what is actual rent. Sir, actual rent is written in this way. Hello, please understand, actual rent is written in this way. Sir, in this chapter, rent is neither taxable on receipt basis nor on accrual basis. Rent is taxable on capacity basis, and that capacity is annual capacity. So I am telling you, my 8 month rent was received. My 8 month rent was received. Alright, rent received for 8 months, alright, and balance 4 months rent was the receivable. Hello, receivable, outstanding rent. Alright, so 8 month rent received and 4 month rent receivable. If you remember our story, you came to me, you said, I'm like CSEMA student, sir, can I stay in your property? And you started paying rent. April you paid, May you paid, June you paid, and then it came to November. You requested, sir, next month I cannot pay the rent. I'll surely pay in January. Alright, January also you did not pay. Alright, you said I will surely pay in Feb. Feb also you did not pay. You said I will surely pay in March. March you did not pay. In April I came here with angry face that I will throw you outside my house property today. Alright, but when I reach here, you had already vacated the property. And I told you have taken everything that you own, not only that you have taken whatever things you own, you have also taken my tube light and lights and fans, yeah. Yes. Curtains.
Yes.
This is the problem, you understand? Then what happened? Then what happened? Come on, tell me. I realized that my 4 month rent is gone.
Yeah.
Alright, unrealized, bad debt, it has become bad debt. So I will be in loss now.
Yes.
Alright, although whole month rent, whole annual rent was accrued, out of that 8 month rent was realized. Balance 4 months which was accrued, now I feel that I may not be realized.
Yes.
I may not be able to realize this particular rent.
Yes.
And I have, by looking at your act, alright, I am 100% sure that it cannot be, it could not be realized now. Alright, and then I will go to income tax department. I will ask my AO, please I want what? Deduction. Yes. I want deduction. Yes. Deduction for what? Deduction for unrealized rent. Deduction for? Now AO may allow, see AO does not, is not under obligation to give you deduction, but he will have certain question and answer session with you, and those questions are written under rule 4. See, I don't remember that I have taught you any rules of income tax. If this is the first head, this is the first rule you are going to learn, and then you cannot afford to forget the rule. Every chapter I will be teaching you one or two rules, not more than that. So in house property we read only one rule, and that rule is rule 4. By the way, rules are written where? Rules are written in, hello, income tax rules 1962. Rule 4 of income tax rule 1962. Sections are from Income Tax Act 1961. So rule 4 of income tax rules 1962 says, the first thing that AO will ask assessee is that whether tenancy was bona fide. Bona fide means, I told you, it has to be genuine. There has to be genuine agreement behind it. Alright. So genuineness he will prove. First question he will ask whether tenancy was bona fide. Second question AO will ask whether tenant has actually vacated your premises. Because if tenant is still there, then you can go and beat him and recover your rent. Hello? Whether tenant has actually vacated your premises, I'll say, sir, yes, tenant has actually vacated the premises. Then he will say, does tenant staying in any other premises owned or controlled by you? Hello? So he is not staying in 101 now, but he is staying in 104. Still you can have access to him. Alright, so they are saying, no sir, he doesn't stay in any other property owned or controlled by me. Then AO will ask, have you taken any step to recover your rent? Was there any security deposit? Did he left any luggage behind? Hello? Do you have his permanent address contract? So I said, yes, I had permanent address contract, but then I asked my staff to go there and that address doesn't exist. That means he has fooled me. That is completely. Then you, David, AO will say, then why didn't you file FIR? So there are two situations now. Either you must have filed FIR, police complaint against this guy. Alright. Or you are telling AO, sir, only for 40,000 rupees, I don't want to go to police station. Alright. Police station will ask me few questions. They will ask for his permanent address. And I have visited that address. It doesn't exist. Alright. And I don't think so that it making any sense of filing FIR on him. Alright, unnecessary, it will be torture and burden to me only. Hello?
Yes.
So you just give me deduction, nothing. I don't want anything from you, I just want deduction. Now you are claiming 40,000 rupees as a deduction, as an unrealized rent. AO may give you 40,000, he may give you less than 40,000, he may reject your claim. That is depending upon your confidence, how you show there. Alright, how you present this particular thing. I am assuming whole 40,000 was allowed as a deduction. Okay, AO is convinced. Alright. So what will you do? Then you will write second point here. What is the second point? Less unrealized rent. But claimed by assessee or allowed by AO?
Allowed by AO.
In exam they will not write it was allowed by AO. They will write rule number 4 conditions complied. Rule number 4 conditions are Complied. Rule number four, conditions complied. That means AO is happy to give you deduction. Am I clear? He has accepted your claim. So you will subtract this particular thing and this is your actual rent. Hello. So tell me mathematical formula for actual rent. Actual rent equal to rent received plus receivable minus unrealized rent allowed by AO. That's a complete sentence. Allowed by AO. As per rule number 4. Am I clear? The discussion we had yesterday and then we stopped our, balanced things. Now let's start with the main chart of GAV. Alright, main chart of GAV. So charging section is done. Concept number 1 was charging section. These are the 3 notes on charging section. These two concepts are pending now, composite rent and stock in trade property. Types of property done. This statement we have written. Alright, this statement we have written, along with that we have created the smileys here. Confused, no, sad, confused and crying and happy. Why is happy? Because he is getting deduction, he is getting losses. Losses are good in income tax. Alright, then you have written what is municipal value and all. You have written what is fair rent, standard rent, expected rent, actual rent. See, this is actual rent formula, mathematical. Rent received plus receivable minus unrealized rent allowed by AO as per rule number 4. Now we have reached to gross value, gross annual value. We have reached to the condition of gross annual value. Alright. So can you please start writing? This is the chart. See, we need this much space. See, this much space we want on gross annual value. This is the main chart. Alright. And below chart we are having cases. Alright. So that I will also write along with you. Otherwise you will get confused in this particular chart. Can you off this projector please for some time? Alright, so what is the concept number? Concept number 8. Concept 8. Gross annual value. GAV. Gross annual value. What is the mathematical formula of GAV? Mathematically, how do you get GAV? Come on, tell me. GAV is equal to, come on tell me, are shameless, expected rent or actual rent, out of this whichever is higher, very simple, isn't it? Alright, so this is by default. I don't have to speak something which is by default that you already know, and we have solved that question from ICA book, CA inter book, that Rajalakshmi question where we have discussed this, how to operate these particular numbers. Am I clear? Alright, now you need to understand something more and something in detail. Okay, now GAV chart. Sir, how GAV chart will operate? Now GAV is the possibility. This is right in 99% situation. Huh? This is right in? But there are 1% chances in exam. Hello, there are 1% chances in exam that this concept may not be applicable like this. Only 1% chance is there. Only 1%. Alright. 99% it will not come in exam, 99, and therefore majority intermediate teacher, they don't teach only this concept because 99% it is not going to come. But you know how lucky you are, something which happens 99 times will not happen with you. You were born exceptionally. Alright, and whatever is not frequent will come in your exam for sure. Alright, something infrequent will come in your exam. So I don't want to take any risk, neither you should take. Okay, so we are talking about GAV chart. GAV in case of no vacancy. GAV in case of no vacancy. No vacancy means house is either occupied by owner or tenant. House is occupied. Hello, no vacancy case means you can please write down here. Okay, occupied by owner or tenant. So this is a no vacancy case. Either it is occupied by owner or it is occupied by tenant. Hello, either it is occupied by owner or it is occupied by Tenant. Very important. Please understand. Please understand. No vacancy case. Alright. In no vacancy case, how do we get GAV? What is the output of GAV? Please understand. Okay. GAV is equal to, very simple, expected rent. You will write expected rent. Hello. And then you will write actual rent. Hey, by the way, what is actual rent? Batani to jhinga gaya. What is actual rent?
Rent
received. Bol na.
Allowed by
AO. And how AO will allow? How AO will allow? By satisfying rule number? Alright. So, expected rent or actual rent, whichever is higher. This is your GAV. Okay? Very easy case. Now, I was not teaching that. That you already know. Alright. I'm teaching you something this. Don't write now. Now, please understand. Please listen now. Have idea and then you write. I'll give you a sufficient time to write it. Now genuinely I'm telling you. Okay, by default, what was the assumption of this chapter? I have spoken about this for more than 1 hour in day one. By default, what is the assumption of this chapter? That assessee will always try to take lower actual rent. At least he will try to show lower actual rent to Government of India. Therefore, what Government of India doing? They are determining their expected rent. Their expected rent or assessee's actual rent, whichever is higher is taxable. Therefore, what is the by default assumption of this chapter? Assessee chore hai. Assessee is a tax evader. Alright. Now, every time it need not to be like true. Okay, majority time assessee will be chore. Hello. But minority time assessee may not be chore. Now, I'm giving you a genuine example. Let us consider your father owns one house property. Okay, this is a house property owned by your father. And it is let out property. Alright. One tenant was staying here for more than 3 years. More than? Yeah. Genuinely now these things will happen. Alright. Now that tenant is vacating house today. The tenant is vacating house today. Do you think that other tenant is standing just outside the gate? No. By whole luggage? One tenant will come out, second tenant will immediately go inside. No. And there won't be even one day vacancy. No. Can it be immediately given on hire to someone else? No. So what are the tasks that we need to do in real world? Okay, forget about theoretical word. In real world, what we have to do? Come on, can you tell me? Now, the first tenant has vacated after 3 years. That means that tenant will spoil the whole room. Paint is spoiled. You can understand, you can see these walls also. You people have written so many things. And now, don't read everything. But you can see, tenant will spoil these walls. Yes or no? Alright, secondly, while leaving house, okay. Now you people are not staying in hostels or something like this, but whenever students, they vacate a hostel, alright, out of love and affection, they break certain things. They break electricity board, they break tube lights, they cut electrical connection just for satisfaction. Achha lagta hai. Alright, they will break this board. Achha lagta hai. Why? Because there will be something with that particular college. They wanted to leave their mark. Alright, so they will break things. Now new tenant is coming and unfortunately he went there and he tried to put that particular switch on and one tenant is died. This should not be the case. Alright. Or owner went there and owner touched that board and he died. Alright. So this should not be the case. So what owner will do? Come on, tell me what owner will do. Before giving on this particular room on again on rent, what owner will do? He will repair, he will ensure that every switch is working properly. Alright, and if it is not working, he'll repair. He means he will give contract to some electrical guy. Alright, some of the water connections in house, alright, your pipeline connections may have leakage. Alright, some of your faucets are broken, taps are broken. Alright, so plumbing work you will do. Overhead tank, bathroom tank or water tank over kitchen would be like having some kind of dust or you know. It's like it has to be cleaned over a period of time. 3 years you did not clean. Now you are giving this particular on flat on again on rent. So you got a time to repair your property. Yes or no? Yes. Alright. So these things will take time. More than 1 week, more than 2 weeks, maybe month. Why? Because owner may not have time to look after these activities. Owner will do as per his own convenience. Hello? Alright. Then after that painting and car painting work will be done. After that, you will call few brokers. You'll say my flat is ready to give on late now. Okay. Then that broker will bring some tenant, prospective tenants. You will have negotiation with your prospective tenants. sometime negotiation may win, sometime negotiation may fail. Alright, either you will adjust with a tenant or you will not adjust with tenant, sometime tenant will not adjust with you, and finally you will get one tenant who is ready to move. That tenant is saying, I'll move, but I'll move after 15 days. This is the token amount. Hello? This may cause genuine vacancy in the property. Genuine vacancy in the property. Sir, then what happens in vacancy case? I will show you what going to happen in vacancy case. So this is a vacancy case. This side is vacancy case, means your property was vacated. Your property was vacated during certain time in previous year. In vacancy case, you need to compare this. Vacancy means 4 months. Let's take example of 4 month vacancy. 4 month vacancy. Now you tell me, should I be paying tax on 8 month, or should I be paying tax on 4 month, or should I be paying tax on 12 month? There are four answers. 8 month property was let out, 4 month property was vacant. You tell me. 12 month. Why your answer is 12 month? Because till now I have told you, or I have taught you, all right, that gross annual value is taxable. Gross annual value is taxable. You are getting my point. Annual value is taxable. Therefore, you must be saying, sir, 12 month is taxable. But genuinely, you tell me, this 4 month, assessee had done for tax evasion. No. Or genuinely it was vacated.
Genuinely.
And we should not torture genuine assessee.
Yes.
Income tax is not there to torture genuine. And genuine assessee will fight to the Supreme Court level.
Yes.
Hello. If assessee is genuine and he is true with his data, then he has courage to fight up to Supreme Court level. And then court will give justice to him if it is something. So they will say, genuinely he has earned rent of 8 months. How can you ask tax on 12 months? Here it is possible, because here assessee is a liar. Alright, here assessee may not be liar, may be liar, but may not be liar. So government has given the right to AO that is, in case of vacancy, you can recompute GAV. There are new formulas of GAV. This is by default formula of GAV, whichever is higher. We are going to modify that formula, and there are three new formulas of GAV. So there are total four formulas of GAV. Out of four, one will come in exam. Hello? 99% this one will come, whichever is higher. Here there is no higher and there is no lower. Alright, simply there will be one formula. GAV is equal to either expected rent, or GAV is equal to either actual rent. Either actual or expected. Actual or expected. Actual or expected. Here only three possibilities are there. So totally you are going to learn four GAV formulas in this chart. There are four GAV formulas in law. Not one. Hello? Four formulas. By default, what is the formula of GAV? Expected rent or actual rent, whichever is higher. But your hand should stop whenever you see vacancy in the case. Hello, question, if it is based on vacancy, you must stop, because now whichever is higher is not a law, some other law. Alright, and this is some other law. Alright, now my case one, okay, here I am writing my cases, okay, case one. Case one, my actual rent is equal to 20,000 rupees per month. Actual rent, 20,000 rupees per month. Let out period is 8 months. Vacancy period is 4 months. And expected rent by government of India is 1,20,000 per annum. This is the data. Do you understand the data? Alright. 1,20,000 is the per annum data of government of India, because municipal values, fair rent and standard rent, this will always be given in a per annum term. Even if they give in month term, you have to convert it into per annum term. Alright, but actual rent, what will be my actual rent? Can you tell me? 20,000 rupees per month, and tenant stayed in property only for 8 months. So what is my actual rent? Hello, come on, tell me my actual rent. 1,60,000, you understand? But please understand this, this is for 8 months, and this is for 12 months. This is for 8 months, and this is for? Even if I don't teach you this law, what will you take? Whichever is? Higher. And what is my higher number? 1,60,000. But that is not a law. Law here says, here GAV is equal to actual rent. GAV is equal to
actual rent.
I did not say whichever is higher. Here law is saying GAV is equal to actual rent, and that is 1,60,000. Hello? GAV is equal to actual rent. Here what is written? Expected rent or actual rent, which here I am saying GAV is equal to actual rent. Hello. And actual means not 12 months, actual means only 8 months. Government is asking us to pay tax only on 1 lakh 60 because assessee, despite